Of class 11. Now here is the diagram explaining how we are going to find solid angle of a body. In this case, the solid angle, the solid body whose solid angle at point O is to be found is drawn in blue ink. And then what we do is we draw a spheroid around the point O where at which point we have to find the solid angle of the body drawn in blue ink. Now once we draw the spheroid, it is a three-dimensional surface, we trace the intercept made by the solid body on the surface of a spheroid, and that area intercepted by the solid body divided by the radius of the square of the radius of the spheroid drawn gives us the solid angle of the body at point O made by a body given in blue ink. So this is all about solid angle. And further, we now move to a new topic, the parallax method. This is a method to estimate large distances wherever it is very hard to reach, and that is done by using the trigonometrical skills. What we do is exactly explained in the diagram. We take a telescope and focus it at any very large distant star. This is taken as the reference direction. Say for example we are doing it from point A, and once it is done, we rotate the telescope and focus any point O on the planet whose distance from Earth is to be measured. Once it is done, we measure the angle by which the telescope needs to be rotated, and then let it be theta 1. And then finally, we wait for 12 hours to reach the diametrically opposite point on the Earth's surface. If we have selected point A on the diameter of the equatorial line of the Earth. So after 12 hours, you see, due to rotational motion of Earth, we reach diametrically opposite point of point A because of rotation of Earth. Earth completes one rotation in 24 hours, so half rotation in 12 hours. So after 12 hours, we again focus the same distant star, and then again rotate the telescope to focus the same point on the planet. And by doing so, by what angle the telescope needed to be rotated, we measure that angle, and if that is theta 1, so theta 1 plus theta 2 becomes the angle AOB, which we call theta altogether. Now we use the definition for plane angle, that is plane angle is equal to arc by radius, and here you see the angle we have measured already. Angle AOB is known to us. Now we don't know the distance AO, that is radius, and then we roughly take the arc AB is equal to the diameter of the Earth. Diameter of the Earth is known to us. And so that way we are knowing the two out of the three terms. Theta is equal to d upon r, we know d diameter of Earth, we know the angle theta, so we can find the distance of planet from Earth, and putting these two value, we get the value of r is equal to theta upon ab, or diameter theta upon diameter of Earth. The same method is applied for finding the distance of distant stars, and similar thing you must have read in class 10, what is called height and distance. Thank you and have a nice day.